Hey guys, Mike here. I'm out at Mongrel's garage, and he was showing me the other day. We took this thing apart, bought this Jeep sort of sight unseen. There was something wrong with the engine, the guy said, and he was right. We were trying to see if we could get this thing fired up and what was wrong. So Brent pulled off the whole front parts here.
Okay, let's start by getting this belt off. That's it. Someplace for safekeeping. All right. Next, we want to start getting some of these accessories off of here. We'll start with the power steering pump. That's going to have to come out of the way. Hopefully we can just move that aside. I don't really want to disconnect all that. Eventually we're going to have to probably pull this rad out. So the power steering pump has some holes in the pulley that you can just get at the bolts very easily. Just run a couple extensions in there. There we go, power steering pump is loose. Trying to get it out of the way a little bit. Next, we'll go after the alternator. It's a little difficult on these because it's down low, but it's not impossible. Get you a little bit better view of what we're doing. I'm trying to get the alternator off right now. Okay. Alternator's loose. Sure do not make it easy to get at the connectors though. It's feeling like a 13 mil. We'll try that. How long is this thing? Oh my goodness.
Well, there we go. We got it.
Sit there and argue with me the whole time, eh? There, now we can get at that a little bit easier. Okay. Oh, look at that. It can come out. All right. I think it's about time we get this radiator out of the way, so I'm going to work on that next.
And we got down into the...
It's called the radiator, Mike.
The radiator, yeah. There we go. We got down into the, what was it, the oil?
We got the timing cover off.
Timing cover, we wanted to get into that to see whether or not it was snapped. Now, whether or not we broke it, or whether it was already broken, the tensioner, apparently.
That's this guy right here, and as you can see,
Two pieces, apparently you're supposed to be one.
Yeah, those are supposed to be one piece. So it is a common failure on these engines. Well, I shouldn't say common when you consider how many millions of these were built, but it's common enough.
Right. Pulled off the
valve covers.
Valve covers, and we put the bore scope down there to have a look, and sure enough, two?
Oh, at least two.
At least two pistons had been smacked pretty good.
Yeah, we got some valves stuck open and stuff like that. So we've analyzed it really well,
yeah.
And we've performed our diagnostic, and we've come up with the conclusion that I think we're just gonna yank it out of there and replace it.
Yeah.
And that's what this guy over here is for, folks. Just turn it around a bit, right there.
So if you saw the recycling video?
The junkyard tips
junkyard
video.
Junkyard tips. This is the good one we got out of the junkyard. We got another one too, but this one's better. So
that's the better one. That's the one we're going to put in. We're going to move everything over from that engine that needs to come off of that engine, put it on that engine, and drop her in. So we're going to get started on that. Stick with us.
Should take us 20 minutes or so.
Yeah, a couple more zeros on that maybe. So we're going to start taking this engine out. I think we're going to try to make our lives a little bit easier by taking the intake off, maybe taking the coil packs off, give us a little more room to work with. It'll also allow me to get back into the transmission bolts very easily. We're going to have to jack this up, get underneath, disconnect a few things. So we're just going to start by doing all that and see where we get to. Yeah. So nice having that, isn't it?
Yeah, that's helpful.
Someone's got lots of tie wraps on the connectors together. Someone was in here at one point.
So 3/8.
Oh, you need the half inch stuff is in the toolbox.
Yeah, well, here, let me try this one.
I can't find it anymore that I cleaned it all up, right? Put it back where it's supposed to go, and I'm not used to that. I should probably give a tutorial on how to get this connector apart because it's a little tricky.
That is probably a good idea.
Maybe go grab the camera. Now, this lever helps push the connector apart, but you don't want to just tug on that because you're going to break it. And you're going to push down in the middle right here. Sometimes there's a lock that you have to pull out first, but we're going to push in the middle, and then you can pull that, pull it back. And if there's any dirt or anything in here, you're going to have to work it a little bit before you just yank it back, because you will break that, and then it's a real pain to get that connector apart. All right, let's carry on.
You know that more cowbell, more extension. Hey.
Take it out anytime, it will drain.
Yeah.
But if you don't want it on your floor, you might want to drain the oil.
Okay.
Yeah.
What about the antifreeze? Or not the antifreeze, the coolant.
Antifreeze and coolant. Oh, the refrigerant.
Refrigerant.
That's what you're going for. We're going to try to leave that intact. We're going to do our darndest to do that, because you have to dispose of that properly.
Mm.
So we're going to do the right thing if we have to get rid of that. And we're going to turn the camera off for the folks. Dispose of that properly, because it's going to take, we're going to have to get someone in here to do it and everything else. And it's kind of boring to film all that. And then we'll turn the camera back on when that's taken care of, if we have to do that. But for now, we're going to just try to move things out of the way, and hopefully we can lift it by.
Okay.
It's not looking promising though.
What are the odds?
Vegas odds? Say 60-1?
I wouldn't say 50-50.
No. 60-1 maybe?
Well, that's worse.
Yeah, that's pretty bad.
Okay. Will we take the intake off?
Yeah, you can start working on getting the injectors undone and the coil packs.
So we're going to do this all again?
Yeah.
And we got to take this off too, right?
Yeah.
Okay. Oh, and we should disconnect the gas this time, right?
Well, we're going to leave that hooked up till the very last, because right. I don't like smelling it.
Sounds good. 10 mil?
8 mil.
8 mil. That's what I said.
Pretty sure that's what I heard. That injector was not coming off of there. You see that leak from it? Well, that's why. Still got the secondary lock on it.
These secondary locks, what do you...
I just use a screwdriver and you'll have to pry them up.
Yep.
They should pop up and you can... Yeah. Problem is if you break the connector because you push too bloody hard on it, which someone has done over here,
oh, yeah?
It makes life very difficult to get that off. In which case, I'll have to try to put a pick or something in there. Well, let's get the oil packs out of the way first, because that'll make life easier.
Okay.
Pry it out of place, it's better to try to just push on the end of your thumb sometimes.
That's what happens, this secondary lock, you just push it that way.
And yeah.
Grab primary lock.
Which is where?
Right there.
Oh, I was pushing on the wrong side. Okay, well, that makes more sense.
Yep,
came off much easier.
Bet it did.
What a surprise.
Put them back on the strut towers.
Those pretty common, though?
The struts?
The brace?
No, not really common. Like, there's a few vehicles that have them.
Yeah.
Those have been around for quite a while, though.
Yeah, I know, I saw that they, you know, you kind of see them on the more powerful cars.
Yeah, well, honestly, this thing is actually pretty powerful, right? You're talking, I think in this trim, it's about 345 horse or something like that with just about 400 foot-pounds of torque.
Really?
So she's pretty twisty. Quite like these Hemis, they do have their issues, as any engine does, but for the most part they can be take care of them, they're very reliable. I'm curious to get this one apart to see how bad it actually is, because I think the bottom end's gone as well. I'm tight turning this thing over. Yeah. If it's just the top end, it might be worth doing something with it, but that bottom, super tight.
Oh, one of those extra screws. One of those parts that you have left over in the bucket.
Yeah.
My Mustang used to have those all the time. Take apart, do something. There's three bolts left. Well, it runs fine, so just throw them away.
Yeah, well, it's you don't have that Mustang anymore, do you?
Nope. It's an SOP. Somebody else's problem.
Yeah. Uh-huh.
We popping the valve covers off, or
no? We'll leave the valve. No, leave those on. But we'll get in the injectors next. Again, it's a double latch system, so there'll be a red one that you have to slide up and then push the black tab. They're a little tricky to see under the spaghetti here, but so
I'll show you. I'm not following.
So here's an injector right here.
Oh, okay.
You see, it's got that red tab there.
Yeah.
So you're gonna just grab your screwdriver and pop that up, and it'll probably break it like that. That's okay. And then squeeze the.
Gotcha.
You're gonna have to four of them. Four,
obviously.
Yep. And I'll do that to you.
Cute. That one.
I don't know what I'm gonna do with this injector. See if I can get a pick in there.
Okay. Now it seems like
I got it
here.
Victory!
Flawless.
I wouldn't say it's flawless.
And I just
what you can see here is that's the beauty about these 05s is that is your main connector to the body.
Mm.
We just disconnected the engine from the rest of the car.
Mm.
You could leave everything in place, but because we're taking this manifold off, I don't want to leave everything in place. But these wiring harness, that's awesome.
Super easy.
Yeah, super easy.
Did
potentially we could have just disconnected that, disconnect the computer, out she comes.
Right. Make it sound so easy.
Well, it is pretty easy.
And that is in need of a sidecar.
Right, I was just going to say, is that the... look at that.
Way here, and off she comes.
Have you been seeing all the sea shanty stuff going around?
No. Way up she rises, way
exactly,
up she rises.
That's exactly
way the way up she rises, early morning. What happens is this runs down. But here, let's get the camera show the folks that we're talking about.
Sure. So what we're looking at down here, folks, is you get the wiring harness going right here. Comes down to your oil pressure sending unit. And then it goes back to your knock sensor, and it goes back to your crankshaft position sensor. Mm. So we have to get under there to get the rest of it off, so we're not going to worry about doing that from up here.
Oh, okay.
Yeah. And it kind of does the same thing on this side. There's some grout. There's going to be a big ground down on this side usually. And then we'll go back to the knock sensor and your starter. So that's what's usually down on that side.
All right. Carry on.
You know what? I didn't pull the radiator out. I've given you a hard time this whole time, and the radiator's still in here. I pulled the fan assembly.
Okay, out. I was going to say,
yeah.
Unless there might have been two.
Well, there kind of is, because you have your radiator, your condenser, your oil cooler, power steering cooler, stuff like that. That's yeah. All.
It seemed like we took a lot of different
a few
types.
Layers of coolers, so one was one type or another. So I guess what I'll get you to do is start getting this intake. So this guy here, it just... yanks up.
Okay.
Usually. Yeah, that's a good idea. Just try to pop that up. Plastic should come up from there.
Maybe I'm on the wrong side of it. There.
Yeah, there you go. And then the same thing back there. Just should be able to just pop it up. And then that, we'll pull this
out of the way. Another vacuum hose of some sort.
Yeah. And then we'll take the spaghetti out. There we go. I'm glad they got rid of that on the newer engines. It's a pain. Look how much cleaner that looks now.
Yeah.
Maybe we should convert convert this over to the newer style. I think that would take a bit of work though.
So is there supposed to be like
mouse nest in there?
A mouse nest.
That's actually, I think they're supposed to be, because I find one every time. So I'm pretty sure it's installed in the back.
It's a vacuum.
Yeah.
Little family of five that lives there.
Yeah. Yeah. Now I don't know why they do it, but yeah.
How the hell did they even get in there? That is so tight.
They don't need much. I think they can fit through something like the diameter of a dime.
Yeah, I think they said as long as their skull can fit through, the rest of it can fit through.
Yeah.
There we go. And then the whole thing lifts, right? Yeah.
Okay.
Oh, you're making the mouse nest unhappy.
Yeah, son of a gun. There you go.
Well, apparently that makes me a son of a gun. Okay, so
see how much of this fuel we can spill in it. Be good.
Stop dripping at any moment, that'd be fine.
Ow! Trailer hitch.
When I put mine on,
at least it wasn't the shim.
Almost do it at least once a day.
Yep. Okay. So down here.
So right here, these are your solenoids to shut down your cylinders when this must go drop into four cylinders. If I recall correctly, let's see. Do you believe they're on 1, 7 and 2 and 6? I can't remember. I'll have to look that up. I don't remember. Can't remember which cylinders it shuts down. But anyways.
Oh, that's for the fuel economy kind of.
Yeah, yeah, that's what gives you the fuel economy.
Gotcha.
And a lot of people, what they'll do is they'll pull these out and put some plugs in there. They'll change this to change the lifter out. So that, and they'll just deactivate that system. Me, I don't mind it. I actually don't mind that system at all. It works okay. My books. I'm not that concerned about it.
So what's this foam for? It's just filler?
Yeah, it's just a heat barrier and stuff. Keep the bottom of the intake insulated. Help keep the air charge a little cooler.
Mm-hmm.
Stuff like that. And for mice.
It's
for mice.
Yeah, it's nice little mice condominium.
Yep.
All right, check this out. Brent's just going to jack it up right now, but we just ripped off the top half of this engine. Came off fairly easily.
You didn't rip it off.
We ripped it off.
Dismantled it.
He was on one side, I was on the other, and you see these muscles? That's how it worked. Just rip.
Okay, so I think we finally have come up with a conclusion of what happened to this engine. I'm pretty sure it was overheated. The reason I'm pretty sure about that is, number one, it's hard to crank. Like, I mean, this thing is tight, and the miles on it, it should not be anywhere near that tight. Number two, if we look down there, and we got the valve seat has dropped. And that usually happens when these things get overheated. So there's that one. We also have one back here on number seven, where that's dropped the valve seat as well. I'm going to get the phone in there pretty clear for you. So, we've got some drop valve seats. And that one might be dropped too, I don't know. That might be okay. But we definitely have some issues there. Can't see in that one. But that one you can see pretty clearly. We got a bad valve seat.